He's Gregg, I'm Joe, and this is I Am Mag Labs. Gregg and Joe TV, presented by I Am Mad Labs.
And this is Jens. Jens. You see this? Look at this fucking magazine, huh? That's a good magazine. It looks like a comic book. Let me tell you something. You guys stop being fucking cheap and start buying this shit. Don't give me that magazines are dead, because we're the only magazine that's going up. All the others are going down, cutting their time. We're fucking over here adding. Our fucking pages have doubled. It's not a pamphlet anymore. You know what I mean? Come on.
Certain magazines are dying.
They are dying.
This fucking one is
dying. Bro, wait a minute. What shirt are you wearing?
I thought you'd never ask. A good friend, Jason fucking Genova, will join us once again.
Hold on. I'm wearing Jason Genova's shirt. I guess we're both wearing a Jason Genova shirt. I know a lot of you guys are going to talk shit, but you know what? Leave the kid alone, okay? Not for nothing, bro. Leave the kid alone. He hurts nobody. I know there's a few of you saying, oh, if you're going to interview him, I'm never going to watch your show. But if you feel that way,
watch it.
Fucking bafungle you, okay? He's not hurting nobody. It's not hurting nobody. You know what I mean? If you're jealous because he's getting all these hits on YouTube making Scott O, then you're with me. I'm jealous too. All right? But no, it's all seriousness, guys. Come on, give the guy a break. You know what I mean? We put him along. Let me tell you something. He promotes us. He works good with us. You promote us. You work good with us. We'll fucking promote you too.
It's very hard to get people to fucking cross-promote. Even guys that we've been very good to. Right, so that's why when I have a guy like Jason who fucking comes through and does the right thing,
absolutely,
I got no problem fucking playing ball with him. And I like the fucking guy. He's our fucking guinea paisan, bro.
Yeah, that's right, bro. He hurts nobody. He bothers nobody. If he's a little bit different than what you feel, that's okay, man. You know what I mean?
I'm different.
He's innocent, man. He doesn't bother nobody. And I like the kid, you know? And he promotes us. We have cover guys that don't fucking promote. We put them on the fucking cover. They tell me, yeah, come on, put me on the cover, boy. We put them on the cover, tumbleweeds and shit.
And not necessarily, you know, this cover, but, you know, just in general.
And this cover. No, but seriously. Just kidding. No, just, if I was half the man I was 7 years ago, I'd take a baseball bat to your fucking head. But anyway.
We digress.
That's the Guinea way, bro. I'm the Bronx. He's Brooklyn. Together with fucking two New York guineas. And you know, it's the way it is.
Big slippery fucking olive oil fucking path.
Well, it's the way it is, bro. Donald Trump all the way. But sorry. Oh my God, no, he's Hitler. He's going to be another Hitler. Oh my God. So in 4 years from now, when there's no concentration camp, you like, remember the Jehovah Witnesses back in the 70s? They'd rent out like Shea Stadium and shit, and they'd sit there and they'd wait. It's the end of the world. You know? They'd all hold hands and sing and shit, waiting for the end of the world to come. And by morning time, they'd leave Shea Stadium. You know, what happened? It was the end of the world. I thought fucking God was going to come down and take you all. Remember all that shit?
Yeah.
Well, you know,
Kumbaya,
I mean,
yeah.
That's, you know, I mean, not for nothing, but, you know, hey, wait, what am I bringing that up for?
I have no fucking
idea.
What
the fuck am I talking
about?
Gotta
go to Brian Kennedy.
I was talking about Donald Trump. And hey, listen, what am I talking about that shit for? That's old news. Hey, listen, MuscleSport Mag, stop being a cheap fuck, okay?
Subscribe, $32 a year, free shipping in the United States, and also subscribe to the YouTube channel. Free. No shipping, no nothing, just free. So we'll be right back with Jason Genova. Gregg, Goliath Labs has been a sponsor of Muscle Sport Magazine since 2008. Basically,
since the site
first came on board. I want to talk about their products here. Isolate protein, 24 grams of protein in this scoop. Unbelievable. Monster Shred pre-workout, Deep Cell Matrix, NO2, NO Monster, Stimuloid, extreme sex stimulant.
Wait, stimuloid. Okay, let's talk about some of these first. Is that stimuloid? What the fuck's that? That's ejaculoid.
Ejaculoid. My personal favorite, actually. Bart is knows it, right, I've now, loved it for years.
Is this the blue capsules?
Yes.
That's the one I gotta tell you something. It works really, really good. But it works almost too good.
It works. Well,
it
you know what?
Fuck me up, man.
Take only one. You don't need to take one.
No, that means it works.
Oh, it works fucking amazing. Tribuloid, Test Booster, Growloid, Humaloid, Herbrex, Sex Enhancer. For men and women, get this for the misses. A perfect stocking stuffer. Go to GoliathLabs.com right now. Hey, Gregg, my buddy Matt from I Am Protect and Lift hooked me up with not only I got a wristband, I got a coffee mug, I got a fucking double-sided t-shirt.
Nice mug.
And this fucking and this fucking cool cap. Hey, these are the guys. This is made for cops, firemen, emergency service workers. This is their gear to wear in the gym. For those who sacrifice every day and put their lives on the line to protect others who cannot protect themselves.
Absolutely.
Apparel, caps, mugs, shaker bottles, mouse pads. Duty gloves, shooting glasses,
duty gloves,
wrist wraps and straps for men and women. So make sure you check these guys out at IamProtectTheLetterNLift.com.
I need the duty gloves.
Hi, this is Lee Priest, and you're watching Gregg and Joe on MuscleSport TV.
And we are being joined right now by our fucking Goomba Paisan in Florida, Jason Genova.
Fellow Italian.
Yep. The Lord himself from freaking Delray and from Boynton Beach, Florida.
Attaboy.
Jason, we love your fucking shirts. We're both sporting them, Gregg and myself. Thank you very much.
The quality's next level. Next level's the best quality t-shirt you can get.
That's right.
It fits good. I got to be honest with you. It fits tight.
It even makes me look, it makes my nose look smaller, believe it or not. It fits so good, which is almost impossible.
Look at this guinea nose.
Basically, I'm getting ready to compete in about 13 days. I'm not eating no carbs right now. I'm on a carb deload right now. I'm basically drinking a lot of water. I'm dropping my water a lot. I'm drinking less water. I'm only drinking half a gallon right now up to this point, and close to the show, hardly anything. So I'm really depleting myself close to the show, and then I'm carb loading the night before the show. So
who preps you, Jason?
I prep myself. I used to be a personal trainer years and years ago, from 2007 to 2009 at LA Fitness on Gateway and Congress in Boynton Beach, Florida.
Right.
My mom used to work there. I used to work there, and I used to be a personal trainer. But I got in a car accident, so I got on physical because of my back, and I couldn't do that anymore.
Really? So wait a minute. Are your parents involved in working out and stuff too, or no?
My mom used to be a personal trainer, a physical therapist.
Oh.
In 2096 at the YMCA in California. Then she moved up here, worked at the YMCA from 2001 to 2005, and then 2006 to about 2001 from the Y to 2003. Then 2005, she worked at LA Fitness in 2009, and then she got into being a chef in 2010.
Oh, nice. Nice. So working out's in the family then, right?
In my mother's side, yes, it's very, very popular. My dad's side, well, my dad was a bodybuilder too back in the 70s. Then he was a construction worker. These fucking construction workers build muscle like fucking crazy, so they're really at it, you know.
Are any of your family from New York? No?
My grandma was born in New York, I think.
Oh, okay. Yeah, because we're New York guineas here, me and Joe. I'm the Bronx, he's Brooklyn.
I think my grandma was born in Brooklyn or the Bronx. I can't remember. I'm not sure. But my grandfather was. They lived in somewhere in New York City at the time back in the 70s. They moved in the 80s, the early 90s to California.
Nice. But did you grow up in California? Or did you grow up in Florida?
I was raised in Northridge. I kept moving. My dad was in the construction business, so every couple of years we just kept moving, hip hopping, bebopping forth. And I moved up here in 2001 when my dad died from cancer. And
oh, I'm
I moved
sorry.
To Florida. I've been here ever since.
Oh, I'm sorry about your dad.
Yeah,
sorry about
me
that.
Me too, buddy.
But about
his boys, though. Let's talk about
the
guys.
Who are the guys that are always, filming you? We always see you walking around, like, who are they your friends?
Delray Misfits. I've heard my crew, Lenny, Brad, all them. Brad gets on my nerves a little bit. He's the knucklehead of the bunch. Andrew's the cameraman, and Lenny's in there, and a couple other characters we have at times. But yeah, they're good people, man.
Who's Brad now? Is that the guy with the beard?
Beard, yeah, right.
Yeah, the one who talks a lot of trash.
But it's fun. I mean, you guys, you know what? You bring entertainment to this fucking sport. It needs entertainment, man. I think the thing with Lenny at Lenny's house and shit, I was fucking laughing my balls off watching those videos.
Yeah, I went in there and I was like, oh, Lenny, you can't look like this, man. Bro, this stinks like fucking cat litter, man.
It looked pretty fucking bad, like, man.
Stunk like cat food, man. It's urine.
Yeah.
And what part of Florida are you guys in now, right now?
I'm in, right now I drove to my mom's house. I'm actually in Delray. I had to pick up some mail for her, but actually I live in Boynton, what's about 20, 25 minutes from my mom's house.
Oh, is that, see, I'm bad with Florida. I actually never been to Florida, but is that like near that, like that Boca Raton or that Fort Lauderdale?
No, Boca Raton's like Delray and then the Boca Raton's next. Boynton's up more where I live.
Oh, okay.
Do you live on your own, Jay?
About 30, 35 minutes to get to Boca, driving if I don't take I-95.
You live by yourself over there?
I got my own condo. I paid for it.
Good.
I earned that shit from all my fucking hits on YouTube, man.
Good for you,
God bro. Bless you, man. God
That's
bless
awesome,
you.
Man.
You know, I'm proud of you. Just you do what you're doing. Don't listen to these idiots on the internet. The internet's full of haters.
They're a bunch of fucking trolls, and I'll tell you something. I got a lot of good things going. The movies, I'm also sponsored with a watch company. They give me watches every month.
Really?
And I'm also, you know, possibly, you know, some car companies, they're going to let me be using their car for YouTube, like every week. It's out of cars and shit every month.
Holy shit.
Starting in April, I'll be driving like a week or two exotic cars, all different types of like Ferraris, Lambos, everything, man.
Meanwhile, I drive a Hyundai Elantra with the bumper held on by a hanger because I let my girlfriend drive it.
In April, I'm driving a Lamborghini, a green one.
Wow, a green Lamborghini. That's awesome, man. Hey, you listen, you know, you put your time in, you know, you work hard and everybody sees you all over the place. I think you earned it. Fuck that.
Yeah, I've been on YouTube since 2008, and I also have over, you know, all together with all the channels and everything people done about me, about 50 to 100 million views, so I'm working my way up, and I'm getting noticed by Hollywood, and I'm getting noticed by different people, and I'm getting more sponsorships and getting salaries, so there's nothing, you know, all the haters can talk all the shit they want, but in the end, you know, I'm banking off them.
Yeah.
Good for you.
Now, are you working a regular job now, or you're just doing this stuff, and you're getting enough money from this stuff?
A couple days a week. The more I keep making, you know, the less I work because, you know, I don't want to waste my time working full-time, you know?
What do you do? What job are you at now?
The grocery store and the stocking department. I hate it. It's just a stress. Now I have so many more back problems.
That's yeah, sure. I hear you. You got the scoliosis, so you got to watch your fucking back, man.
Like, scoliosis. It's not, like, severe yet. That's why I'm getting treated. And, this is a watch company. They're actually giving me these, if I can show you. Ugh, God.
Oh, there you go. That's nice. I saw that in one of your videos.
Every month they're giving me watches, and they're giving me different types, and also I'm getting, different other watch companies are also sponsoring me, like Renato, Omega. They're all sponsoring me because they see my followers are growing, you know?
Yeah, as long as it ain't Walt Disney, right? You don't want one of their fucking Mickey Mouse watches.
No, I don't.
I'm just fucking with you, bro. Hey, so we got to go to break now, so we're going to have to let you go. So what else is going on right on the way out? We got to do it quick.
I'm getting ready for the show. Just have me back on after the show. I'll tell you how I did. And
of course.
Also that I'm getting ready to compete in September also. And moving to L.A. hopefully by sometime next year. So I'll keep in tune with you guys and keep you in check. And after the show, I'll be back on the show. And I'll keep you guys in mind if I got politically robbed or whatever. What my opinion on the show, you know?
Jason, you are always welcome on our show.
You're always welcome here.
You're one of our fucking buddies,
and if you're ever
bro.
Up in New York, we'll really romp around.
All right, bro. I'll let you go.
Thanks,
Jay.
All right,
Jason. Take care. Much love to you.
Be good. All right, bye. You might be asking yourself, what the fuck are these guys wearing? Gregg and I are wearing the oversized rag sleeve workout top from tmichael.com. M-I-C-H-E-A-L, not the common spelling, so make sure you log in correctly because you won't get their site if you go in there. They got their Powerhouse Gym, Automix, World Gym, NPC, Zubaz, Chic. They got all the brands you want. Performance, footwear, gorilla wear, 3X, up to 3X with their big tops. Tees, tank tops, sweatshirts, hoodies, everything. TMichael.com. Hey, who wants some free shit?
I always want free shit.
Hey, it's a good, easy way. Look at these pink straps. They're perfect for me. Match my panties. Riptone.com. Check it out. We're having a contest to the end of fucking April. You got plenty of time to fucking enter this contest. Very simple. Three winners are going to be picked, and then you're going to get one of these great items per winner. You're going to like the video that you're watching on YouTube right now. You're going to share it on Facebook, and then you're going to put hashtag Riptoned MSTV. Riptoned MSTV. Got it? Very fucking easy, bro. And then you're going to get one
Don't
of these
be
great
cheap.
Items. And even though I'm going to keep these because I'm fucking lame, only a girl will get these. So, guys and girls, please. We got some cool shit for you. Don't forget.
Like chain. The bling.
Look, you can even look like bling bling.
Stop
After the
fucking
contest
around.
Right now.
Stop fucking around into the fucking contest. Share this shit. Don't cost you fucking nothing, you cheap bastards.
This is Dave Palumbo from RxMuscle.com, and you're watching Joe and Gregg on MuscleSport TV.
Hey, welcome back. Gregg and Joe TV, presented by RMag Labs on the MuscleSport TV network.
Yep.
Hey, right. These guys like Genova out there, man, they're fucking, I mean, they're getting a lot of popularity, bro.
Dude,
there's no two ways about it.
Dude, listen to me. You know, you got a lot of people today that are celebrities strictly because of social media.
Yep.
I mean, because they have a huge Facebook following. They, look at that girl that you used to send pictures and you used to tell me about. You know, she was all that
Jen Selta.
Yeah.
She's from out here, Long Island.
Dude, yeah. I don't give a shit. Every picture, just her ass.
You ever
shit.
See Mama Selta, her mother's Instagram account?
No, don't
her
tell me.
Her mother's got a fucking ass just like hers. Yep. And she has a sister. There's three asses I would eat
yeah,
in one
you know
fucking
what,
household.
Yeah, but you know what's funny though, Joe? Not for nothing, but those asses are not. First of all, they're not my type. They're big asses. I like a little ass, you know.
Little ass.
Remember the movie? There's a famous line in the movie True Lies called, you know, with Bill Paxton,
who
by the way just died.
Yeah.
And you know, he was talking about Arnold Schwarzenegger because he's telling Arnold Schwarzenegger, who's in a car with him, and he's banging Jamie Lee Curtis, Arnold's wife, and he's telling him, you know something? She's got an ass. I mean, it's tight and small. It's like a 10-year-old boy's ass. You know what I mean? And he says that to Arnold, and Arnold's looking at him like he's gonna, like I'm gonna crush you.
But he's got to play it off that he doesn't know who she is.
But I know, dude. Yeah. That's the ass I like. I like a girl with a small, like I like. Like skinny girl.
So do you like Jason Genova's ass though?
You know, I his ass might be a little bit big for me.
Really? But he dyed it down though.
Yeah, but does he shave it?
I haven't got that close to him yet. we're still just getting to know each other. Not that well yet.
No, but in all seriousness, it's just like, you know, all these guys, they tattoo their faces or they tattoo their bodies. They walk around.
You gotta one up the next guy.
You know, and it's all, you know, social media, you know what I'm saying? If it wasn't for social media, mm-hmm. all this stuff right now has brought these people, you know, instant fame. And they really believe, though. They really believe, like, that they're you know, like, famous. You know what I mean? Like, you know, you go into a store and, you know, I mean, look, let's use somebody who's real right now at the top of our sport, Rich Piana. Now, I like Rich, you know, and, mm-hmm. you know, he works here with us and everything. You know, his people are part of MuscleSport Mac. But I'm saying to you, you know, to the rest of the world, they see him walking the store. They don't go, holy shit, that's Rich Piana from 5%. They say, well, what the fuck is that? You know what I mean? Look at that guy with a, oh, is he a wrestler? You know, is he a football player? Or, you know, is he a, like, Hell's Angel? They don't know. Yeah. You know, you know, especially in bodybuilding, it's all niche. You see these guys, you know what really kills me? Those guys that are, like, all from Shreds. You know, oh, that Joe Swole, Jason Swole, yeah. You know, my ball Swole, you know what I'm saying? All those fucking guys, bro. You know, they're standing with their fucking abs and taking endless cell phone pictures of themselves, you know. Dude, look, you look good because you're 22, 23 years old.
Juice when I was 20, mind.
Yeah, right, juice daddy mind, do not for nothing.
Which but is fine, that's not wrong with that.
If I took the juice that they took, I'd make Big Ramy look like a fucking zit. You know what I mean? But let me tell you something. When you're 23, I just saw pictures of you out here when you got married. How old were you?
27, actually.
Are you a 27?
I had a fucking hell of a mullet, too.
Right, you know, people... no offense, but, you know, people say...
I didn't always look like Al Bundy.
That's what I was gonna say. People say you look like Al Bundy. I look like Uncle Fester. I didn't always look like this. When I was their age, I looked good. Wait till you see these fucking Joe Matarazzo Swole. You know what I mean? Wait till you see him.
In 30 years.
Right, fucking 30 years. We just got gray nose hairs and fucking shit going on. I used to be Joe Matarazzo Swole. You know what I mean? Do you ever see some of these fucking bodybuilders when they're older, even in my age? Dude, I'm going to be 56. Shit. Hey, come on, look at me. I'm going to be 57 years old. You know what I mean? I still take care of myself. These fucking guys, I see guys from even the 80s, these bodybuilders, I'm like, holy shit, what happened to him? Yeah. You know what I mean?
No, a lot of them are fucking
just saying,
busted,
but
man.
Today, you know, the internet's making all these guys like, you know, hey, I'm fucking Joe Matarazzo, you saw me on fucking YouTube, I got 100,000 followers, and, you know, really? You know? I mean...
Listen, I guess, you know, listen, it's everybody's 15 minutes. I wish I had 100,000 followers on YouTube.
I do too.
These guys are onto something. We're fucking wrong.
No, but wait. Listen, but I want to say something, you know. Like, you know, and so anybody that ranks down Jason, you know, Genova, is an asshole because he's not doing anything that nobody else is doing. You know, let him fucking get his time. This is his time. He's young.
Yeah.
He's doing nothing that nobody else is doing. If you guys don't like somebody like Jason or even me, don't watch my videos. Don't give me the click. Right? That's the whole bottom line to it. If you don't like it, don't click on it, motherfucker. But you guys, you know what's funny? Any of you people that are fucking complaining about social media and you know, and all these like social media heroes now and all that shit, you don't like it. Oh, I can't stand Rich Piana, or I can't stand Valentino, or I can't stand fucking Jason Genova. Don't. You created it. You created those guys, so don't click on it. You know what I mean?
It's alive.
That's right, dude,
Frankenstein.
Dude, Dr. Frankenstein created the Frankenstein monster. He created the monster that killed him.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And dude, that's what I'm saying. It's that people Boris complain Kolov, about these guys.
1931.
Yeah. Well, now it's fucking 1960. What the fuck is it? It's not
2017.
Holy fuck.
We're getting old.
Holy shit, man. I'm still in the 1900s. No, but, you know, now in this era, it's you people who created these people on YouTube and Facebook. And even if they're a train wreck, you know, that little girl that's got Pedroria or whatever. The little girl.
I know what you mean. The little girl, she comes out when they die of old age at 8.
Yeah, but I mean, no, but I'm saying... Oh, that's
Progeria.
Yeah, but there's a little girl, and she's doing.
I used to go to high school with him, Frankie Progeria.
Manon.
We gotta go. Manon. Break, bro.
Stop creating these fucking guys.
Keep creating them as long as they're us. We'll see you on the other
side.
Yeah,
that's good.
International Protein, Australia's leading supplement company, leading the way for over a decade. Now, the all-new performance range. Leading the way is International Protein's Superior Whey. Superior Whey's gut-friendly formulation is perfect for athletes at any training level. Do you train hard and work hard? Protein Synergy 5 ensures a steady supply of muscle-building protein for up to 7 hours. Looking to burn fat and maintain muscle? IsoCut's active levels of green tea, natural caffeine and hydroxycitric acid ensures IsoCut's will be your new partner in your weight management goals. Want to get to the next level? International Protein's amino-charged WPI will get you there. Intense aerobic or heavy anaerobic training requires a fast recovery. International Protein's Amino Recovery is developed to help achieve the fastest recovery possible.
International Protein's all-new performance range, trusted by Australia's elite athletes to deliver the best-tasting food for growth.
Gregg and Joe on MuscleSport TV.
Hey, MuscleSport TV, Gregg and Joe, what's up?
You know, Joe, I gotta ask you a question.
Go ahead.
I just was watching this video with this guy, Dr. Tony Hughes, right? And he's talking about this new steroid that's out, and he says it's more anabolic and better than the best steroid out there. And I thought maybe he's gonna talk about Tren or fucking Anadrol. It's called Ment. Have you ever heard of that?
This is something that, when you first talked to me about that, I never fucking heard of this thing until then. I'm like, wow, where the fuck have we been hiding?
I thought, but you know, yeah, that's why, dude, let me tell you something. I, you know, I'm a fucking ex-drug dealer. Hello. Okay? But I'm thinking about, like, is this something that, like, maybe he fabricated himself and now he's trying to push it out there? Oh, I'm taking this shit, Ment, you know? Like, in other words, like, if you and I came out with, like, a fucking protein powder, and we keep pushing out, oh, there's this new protein powder, bro. It's unbelievable. I mean, I don't know if it's legit, but then I've seen other fucking guys talk about it.
But it's all over the place.
Now, all of a sudden, I never heard of it, though. I mean, I believe that this fucking guy didn't do it. I mean, I believe that there is a new hormone called it. Because he was saying that this shit can actually be, like, a doctor can prescribe it to you.
Yeah, but that makes it even more like, holy fuck.
What? Yeah, because, like, why wouldn't you go from, I mean, you know.
Why would you just take fucking 200 milligrams a test? When would you just, they said that's way more anabolic,
but he's saying,
than Tren even.
He's saying that this Ment is better than testosterone, better than Tren, better than Anadrol.
And, which those are usually the top dogs.
He's saying it's easier on your system. It's less side effects, more anabolic.
Where do I sign?
I'm thinking, where the fuck is my doctor? You know what I mean? My fucking testosterone's so low right now. It's like maybe of a fifth grade girl. You know what I mean? Matter of fact, my nipples are itching. But no, I'm just kidding you. My girlfriend's actually in the studio for the first time, sitting over here. She won't. Hi, honey.
Say hi. Come on.
She won't. She won't say.
She won't fucking get on camera. She won't even have a voice on
camera.
Look at
her. She's sitting there. She's like, motherfucker, where's your Visa card? I'm going to the mall. My workout. I'm going to work out today. I'm going to the mall. Forever 21. But anyway, so I'm sitting there and I'm like, fucking Ment. You know what I mean? Like, I want to know more about this shit, you know? So I think I sent you a video, didn't I, or no?
Yes, you did. I would love to talk to Dr. Tony Hughes. I'd love to get him on this show.
We got to get this guy on. I need to talk about
it. I definitely want to talk, because this is very interesting.
Dude, it is. He's saying that this is the new
best
thing.
Juice in town.
And he's saying that they're giving it out like fucking HRT and shit like that. And it's got no side effects. It's not hard on the liver.
We should ask anabolic doc about it. Tom O'Connor. We should ask him. What does he know about it? Because he's a fucking doctor. Yeah, so he might have a little inside track on this stuff.
He is a doctor, but he's kind of a little negative on this.
Well, he doesn't want to just people to abuse it.
That's
he wants to
agree.
Keep it in fucking healthy dosage.
I got to be honest with you. I kind of want to abuse it.
Me too.
I kind of want to abuse it. I mean, fucking A, I abused Anadrol. You know, I was taking like 6,000 milligrams. I was a drug dealer, so I had it like that. You know what I mean? I was taking like 6,000 milligrams of Tespro. I know that this makes the fit your macros guys like all fucking excited. But let me tell you something. I could eat a fucking whole pizza pie, you know, spaghetti meatballs and shit. I never got fat. And
still have fucking six pack.
Still never got fat. When you're taking that much test, bro, forget it. I'm just saying, holy Christ.
It's like if you're telling a guy, hey, this is going to make you feel, lift, fuck like you were fucking 20 again.
I don't understand.
But you're not supposed to take it. It might hurt you 50 years from now. So my girlfriend, be careful with it.
My girlfriend's ears just went up like this when she said fuck like you're 20 again. You know, she just left her 20s. I'm fucking, you know, 57. She's like, maybe he needs to take that mint. Anyway, simmer down, you. Anyway,
Mentos.
if you guys are out there and you're like, what the fuck are they talking about? Google MENT. It's testosterone.
Just ment steroids.
Yeah, it'll, ment.
You'll see a shitload of Google.
Dude, I'm sitting here. I'm like, what the fuck, dude? You know, I feel like I'm kind of not an expert, but kind of an expert. You know what I mean? Because I was a drug dealer before. I got everything, bro, and I got the steroids. It was real. And this is back in the '90s, so simmer down. But I'm sitting here going, I never heard of this shit, you know? And I'm thinking, where the fuck is my doctor, you know? Because, you know, my shit's like, fucking forget about it. I had my testosterone was like barely 100, you know?
Oh, God.
It's bad, bro. It's bad. It's fucking bad.
Did you need a strap on? Get a hot on? You need one of those extenders they have for the Irish guys?
Don't give her any ideas about strap ons. Holy Christ. Holy Christ.
Under 100, bro.
Yeah, dude.
That is like bad. Fucking horrendous.
It's bad. You know what I tell you what I did do, though? And it raised my test a little bit. I took letrozole. You know letrozole?
Yeah.
It kills. If you take it every other day, a pill, it's which is 2.5. It kills estrogen. It kills fucking prolactin, too.
So
even though you can take the caber.
It counteracts, it counterbalances.
But it kind of boosts your test, you know? So
because the body feels less, the estrogen has to make up for it, so it pushes a little test up.
Right.
That's what test boosts. They're all fucking whatever. We can't say those because some of our sponsors like to sell those.
Oh, yeah.
But hey.
Oh, test boosts are great.
Speaking of sponsors, we got to take a quick break before I piss one of them off. They're all great. Buy everything.
Yeah, please.
See you back on the other side.
Hey Robert, it's Jay Cutler, four-time Mr. Olympia here. I want to send a big thank you to yourself and your company, Pumped Up Fitness Nutrition, for the support of Cutler Nutrition.
What's up everyone, this is Rich Piana. I just want to let you guys know, you can get all my supplements at Pumped Up Fitness Nutrition.
At Pumped Up Fitness Nutrition.
Pumped Up Fitness Nutrition. I will see you there.
God damn it.
Pumped Up Fitness Nutrition. The Hulk will be you.
Store is freaking awesome, man. Pumped Up Fitness and Nutrition.
God damn it.
Come here, get all your 5% needs. You know, everything's fully in stock at all times here. It's 100% in stock. This store is fucking awesome.
I look forward to seeing you guys soon.
Where else?
Where else?
And you know you got a good fucking product when they call it the Champions Club, Greg, right?
Oh, yes, you do.
Steroid-club.com.
You had me at steroids.
Your privacy is very important. They have everything you want there, pretty much.
Everything?
They even got fat burners, anti-estrogens, sex pills, liver cleansing, painkillers, injectables, pills, peptides, all that good shit. Packages available from beginner to advanced cycles. And mass and cut cycles also. They have, you know, nice little kits together. Make sure you go to steroid-club.com.
Been there, sold that.
This is Jerry Ward from BioWestry Training at Primeval Labs. And this is the Greg and Joe MuscleSport TV show Bicep, and we're out.
And just like that, we're out of fucking time once again. Greg and Joe, Joe and Greg, MuscleSport TV.
Joe hates when I do that. Now, listen, guys, I just want to, can I just say something, Joey?
No.
I'm going to say it anyway. Listen, guys, you know what? If you like the videos that we're doing, you know, obviously subscribe the whole bit. But, you know, leave, you can leave your comments here. Just don't be dicks about it. You know what I mean? Like stupid shit. But if there's some negative comments, we're open to, you know.
It's fine.
Because we want to hear what you guys have to say about this. All right? We want to know what you guys really think. You know? Not that we give a shit, but we want to know. But, sorry. Listen, but, no, really, we do want to hear your comments, even if they're negative. But, you know, I don't want stupid shit. Like, you know, you two should, you know, shit on each other or something stupid. You know what I mean?
That might be fun. You want to try it?
Hey, ask Joey Matarazzo. Joe Matarazzo. Hey, what you got to know? What do you say? What do you know? So, anyway, leave your comments below, all right? And if you want to fight amongst each other, that's okay. We're not like Jerry Ward. You know what I mean? Even though this is the fucking MSM bicep.
We're out.
And we're out.
I love Jerry.
I love Jerry. Jerry's my boy. But listen, just, you know, give us some feedback, though. We're open to your comments. See, what do you want to see us do? Okay? Besides 69 each other.
Oh, fuck. I can get on top. We'll see you next time.
Fuck off. Stop being so fucking cheap. I'm fucking around.